Life tends to happen while you're still making a plan. So dare to dream big, cause it's worth taking a chance. And when tomorrow comes, you will know you gave everything. So just do what you love and love what you do. There's so many things in life and they're all here for you.
Hello everyone, this is Lady Phoenix. Welcome to my channel, and today this is a response to one of the video requests that I had from a lovely lady. Thank you so much for requesting, and also a gentleman. And I'm sorry I don't have your names here, and I don't know if I have permission to use your names, so I'm not going to use your names today. But I wanted to give you a couple of tips that you guys wanted to know how to clean stethoscopes. How do you clean your stethoscope? Well, I'm going to tell you, it's a very simple step that you have to do, and all you need is one single alcohol prep pad, just like this. This is all you need. So what you want to do is just open it up. I'm not going to open it right now for saving this alcohol pad purposes, but all you would do is take the alcohol prep pad and just wipe it down. Just, you know, swipe it down a couple times, a couple seconds. Don't forget to clean your bell. And voila, that's all it takes. And then you want to take an alcohol pad, and also don't forget about your tubing. You got to go down the tubing and clean that as well. That's just an added precaution, because sometimes you have the stethoscope, you're wearing it around, and what happens is, you know, you have all these germs in there, and you have all the germs there, and they're just hanging on and sticking to your clothes. So which comes to a couple of tips I want to give you as far as keeping your stethoscope clean and yourself clean, and to prevent infection, transmission of viruses, bacteria, things like that. You want to make sure, I don't know about you, I personally loved carrying it like this, carrying the stethoscope like this, because, well, it was a little bit easier. But I found that, you know, I started realizing after I started nursing in nursing school that it's better to just kind of coil it up like this, and then just put it inside your pocket, in your scrubs, in your lab coat, whatever you might be wearing that has pockets in it. And I think they also sell some gadgets that you could put. It's like a little, kind of looks like kind of like a little tool belt kind of thing that has a little clip on it, and you could clip it on there as well. So whatever you prefer, but the main idea is to, you know, not have it around here, because, you know, you're going to be, you know, whatever it is, if you haven't had time to clean it or whatever. I've seen people that come out of the rooms and they right away they come out and they put their stethoscope here. Well, they're putting all this, introducing all these germs into their lab coat, their scrubs and whatnot, and then they wonder why they get sick, right? So they're carrying those germs around. Another tip I want to give you is the tip about not cleaning the stethoscope where the patient doesn't see you. I made it a general rule to, as a nurse, you know, to just carry my little alcohol prep pads. I always had, like, my bags were like, I walked around looking like an astronaut, because I always had a whole bunch, you know. It's like I was all, you know, puffy. I'm still puffy, but I want to say I had a whole bunch of alcohol prep pads in my pockets, and because even in my pants pocket, in my scrub pockets, everywhere, just because you're going to need them all the time. And so what I would do is, instead of waiting for the patient to ask me, if, you know, nobody really asks, but, you know, sometimes a patient may ask you. So I wanted to make sure that they knew that I was doing the, you know, providing the best care that I could. So I would take out my alcohol prep pad, and before I was going to listen, before I put it on and listen to the patient, I would stand there in front of them and just take it out and just start cleaning it, or tell them, let me just clean my stethoscope really quick, clean it all around so they would see it, and then I would go and place it on their skin. Because, you know, you have to wonder as a patient, you know, is the nurse nurse or the doctor, whatever it may be, or any healthcare professional that may be tending to that patient, you know, are they going to clean their hands? Did they wash their hands? Did they clean the stethoscope? You know, patients may be wondering about that, and they may be a little bit shy about asking you. So you don't want to worry them, you know, more than they have to already with whatever problems they're going through medically. So you want to do it in front of them. That's what I, you know, got accustomed to doing, and patients just loved the fact that I, you know, they could see, you know, that it's clean. So, and some of them would even tell me things like, oh, I never thought about that, or, I'm glad that you're doing that in front so I could see, because sometimes I wonder. So, yeah, you do have those wondering patients, and they're kind of afraid to ask you. Which brings me to my next point. For those of you that are not necessarily medical professionals, but are patients, because if you're not in the medical field, you're going to be a patient, nevertheless, sooner or later, my friends, because we don't live forever, and we're not 100% always well. So we are ill sometimes, so you are going to be sick sometimes, and at some point in your life, you're going to encounter a nurse, a doctor, whatever. I want to just encourage you to not be afraid to ask your doctor, your nurses, x-ray technicians, whoever it may be, lab technicians that come to draw your blood. Ask them, did you wash your hands? Did you sterilize your equipment, whatever? Did you wash the stethoscope, and stuff like that? Don't be afraid to ask if in doubt, because it is a valid question. It is your right, so go ahead and ask that. I know there's some gadgets out there that I've seen. I forgot what they're called. God, it's not at the top of my head right now, but it's some kind of little gadget where, you put this as like a little magnetic clip that you wear on your coat or whatnot, and then you're supposed to insert the diaphragm in the little clip, and there's like a little sponge in there. And every time you slip it in there, I guess it's supposed to clean the stethoscope. The only thing about that is you have to change the sponge every day. And I have a thing, kind of like a, I don't know, a phobia, if you will, that, some of these sponges, will collect germs and they might stay there. I don't know. It's just, it might be, I know that it's been proven effective and that, it's supposed to, it's supposed to have not harmful chemicals, if you will, but who knows with all these chemicals they put in our foods and our everything else, who knows what they put on those sponges. But I'm just anal. I'm just like that. I'm just weird like that. So I prefer the sponge, the not the sponge. I prefer the good old handy dandy alcohol prep pad, and just take your stethoscope and just wipe it down. Wait, I would say for about 10 seconds before to let it, air dry a little bit, and that's pretty much it. That's all you do to actually, just keep your stethoscope healthy, keep yourself healthy, and keep your patients healthy and your doctors and everyone else. Because once you go around, transmitting the bacteria, it stays all over. You're transferring it to the patient, to your coworkers, to yourself, and big no-no, right? Because you're transferring bacteria, viruses, and all that stuff. The other thing I want to tell you, mention, the last thing I want to mention is that when you're wearing your stethoscope, whether it's here or on the scrub or whatever, a lot of times it gets in our way, and I know that you run off and maybe you're going to lunch or you're going somewhere else, I don't know, to run an errand or whatnot, and you don't need the stethoscope for a little while, let's say half an hour or whatever, and you take it off, and I've seen a lot of nurses, they hang it on the doorknob of whatever door is available. And that's another big no-no, because you don't know if somebody didn't wash it, or maybe another nurse walks up to that stethoscope and they can't find. I've seen this happen many times. That's why I'm telling you. One of the nurses will walk up and say, "Hey, can I use your stethoscope?" And you'll be like, "Yeah, I'm not using it for now, for like 30 minutes or whatever." Then they come back and then they hang it on the door, and you don't know what they used it for in there. I mean, we're dealing, I'm sorry, I don't want to gross you out if you're eating, but we are used to dealing with a whole bunch of bodily fluids, and I don't mean in a good way. But anyhow, you'd never know what your stethoscope touched, guys. So imagine, that they're cleaning poop or whatnot, who knows, and they've got a, I don't know, C. diff or whatever. What? They got something they're going to transmit to, to the stethoscope, and then this isn't your stethoscope. You go hang it on the door for the return it back to the nurse that had it on hanging on the door, and that nurse comes and picks it up. It doesn't even know, and they're hanging it on their neck or, bringing it to another patient and so on and so forth. You get the idea, right? So those are just a couple of tips I wanted to give you extra, but basically it is just plain and simple. Just wipe it down with an alcohol pad. So that is my best tip I can give you as far as cleaning the stethoscope. And I hope I've answered all your questions. If I haven't, please, or if you would like more information, please go ahead and let me know down below or in private. Whatever you like is great, and I really appreciate your friendship and your questions and your request. And I do want to apologize for taking a little while to do it. I know I had done another stethoscope video, but it was a little bit more fancier, if you will, if you want to say that word. Those of you that saw my stethoscope video know what I'm talking about. But I wanted to make this one a little bit more on the basic. So anyway, thanks so much for watching. If you like this video, please go ahead and like, share with your friends, subscribe for my next video, and don't forget to comment down below, as I really am looking forward to your comments. Thank you so much, and have a terrific day. This is Lady Phoenix, and I'll see you next time.